Hi traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning: your invested capital may be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose. And this video is not investment advice. So this video is another candlestick chart analysis video. I'm going to show you how I analyze candlestick patterns, chart patterns, and the chart. Yes, and on those kind of analysis, I will do my trades. So let me see what I can show you now here. We have here some kind of uptrend. It's really low volume market. I don't know why. Maybe because of this huge candlestick here. But here is forming those what I would call here an engulfing candle. And after this engulfing candle, I'm preparing to do a call here. Yes, I will do a call because I'm pretty much sure that price will go up further. Market is doing some kind of panic, yes, but that is what I have explained to you so often. We have here the combination of an engulfing candle with an inverted bullish hammer, which is for me a sign that we are going now in an uptrend. Also, if we have here the 20 EMA close, yes, but that is no problem because you see the candlesticks are so tiny, there is not large volume into this market. That means that I don't expect a big huge in the money. I expect only a little movement. I waited till I get a better entry point on this level here. You see here are a lot of wicks here of this doji, and that are they, those one are protecting my bet, yes, and that is what I expected. So let's see, you see it was a close in the money only, yes, because okay, now I'm expecting that we are getting a big down movement, yes, and that's the reason why I did the put now. The entry point is not so nice, but I'm pretty much sure that price will go down really huge, yes, because the overall trend is down, yes, and I'm expecting after this doji here that price will go down further, because you see we get here in a consolidation area, and I'm expecting that price will break out downwards, yes, and that's the reason why I entered into a put. So let's see what will happen. So another 19 seconds. Yes, and you see it's going down like I have expected, and I think it will go down further because mostly it will go down below this wick of the previous doji. So let's see. Okay, it was a draw because it closed exactly on the doji because we have so low volume. Yes, it's really low volume here. So I will do another call, and the problem is here I have to wait for a I don't do a put now because I'm expecting here that we are getting now into a consolidation area, yes, and after this I will not do any kind of candlestick analysis because you see how the Bollinger Band is squeezing, yes, and that means that the next candle will not listen to price action and to candlestick analysis, and that's the reason why I will not do any kind of trade after this till the consolidation area is over, yes, because it could be now really tricky. You see this is a box here, that box of this consolidation area, so and that is the tricky part here, and you see it's got a huge movement because of this evening star, and you see it's immediately starting here in the wrong direction. I don't know what will happen here because we are here in a consolidation area. It can happen everything. And so I will try to avoid any kind of trade. So let me see if I can show you some trades which I would have done here. So you have seen I have traded this kind of candlestick here after this on this resistance area. And I have traded this kind of candlestick here, which was a continuation of the trend, yes, of this evening star. And I have explained this also often, that if you have some kind of candlestick pattern, engulfing candle, morning star, evening star, or some kind of chart pattern, after those kind of patterns, you get almost a strong trend, yes, a nice trend. And then it's most favorable to do continuation trades, yes. So example here, after this kind of candle, I would do this kind of call here, yes, and probably also this kind of call, but I would wait to get a better entry point, yes, because you see here we have those kind of things. And this is also one of those no rejection setups which I have explained also in my ebook. So get this ebook, don't forget it, yes, and study those things which are explained there. So we have here a round number, yes, 1.172. And so I would do also this kind of trade here after this doji here, Gravestone doji, because you see the price was almost below this, and then I would enter into this kind of candle only because of this resistance area here. So, and here I would probably not doing any kind of trade. This here is a dark cloud cover, but because all those kind of candles are so tiny, I would try to avoid any kind of trade here, because here you don't know what will happen if price will reject from the 20 EMA and then closing above, because here it was an uptrend, but here I would not trade. Almost because the candlesticks are too tiny. If you have so tiny candlesticks, you have to wait to get some better clue, yes, and only really good candlesticks which are telling what is happening. So for example, I would trade here in this kind of scenario where we have really a lot of tiny candlesticks, only this kind of trade here after this hammer here, which is not a really nice hammer but a good one, yes. And that would be almost everything. That's what I would have trade. This kind of, if you have such kind of small candlesticks, try to avoid to trade this, because it could be that IQ option is showing you here some kind of spinning tops or something like else, something else. But it could be also a doji. It could be everything, yes. It could be also little pin bars. So at the end, you don't know what these candlesticks are, the meaning of these candlesticks. In my opinion, all those candlesticks in this area here are telling you only one thing, that there is indecision, and that is not nice to trade all so low volume that they don't know what will happen. So avoid such kind of trading here, yes. You see here for 1 hour, there was no trading. Yes, because of those kind of candlesticks. You can do some trades if you want to, but this is then more like gambling instead of a good trading behavior. So if you have such kind of scenario, try to trade, like I have explained in the last videos, at the edges of the Bollinger Band. For example, here you have flat EMAs, yes. Here, this kind of candle could be traded here because of this kind of resistance, and you see here the flat 200 EMA. So you could do here trade because price tries mostly to range around the 200 EMA. But else, I would try to avoid here any kind of trade, and especially in between of the EMAs here. You see, in between of EMAs, don't trade, because you don't know from which EMA price will reject and from what not, and that would be not good, yes. So be so disciplined as not to trade in such kind of scenarios, yes, and such market conditions. So here I would also not trade. You see, that would be a nice trade, this would be nice, but only if you understand here the 200 EMA, then you could enter here into a trade. But I would not recommend to do such kind of trade if you are not experienced, yes. Then I would do this kind of trade here, yes, and probably this kind of trade, because this is telling me that the this is telling me that the reversal has occurred now, yes, and that is what I'm telling you. You need to wait if you are doing, because somebody asked me this, if you are doing reversal trades at Bollinger Bands. You cannot trade Bollinger Band reversals like this one, for example, yes, only because there is a candle, you do the next, yes. That will be not good, because you will lose a lot of trades. Sometimes you will win, yes, but sometimes you will lose much more than you win, because you because it looks from the rejection, it looks like it would be a reversal, but then the downtrend will continue, yes. That is what the risky part is. But if you wait for such kind of scenario here, you get a doji, you get an inverted bullish hammer, then you can enter into this kind of trades here almost also, because you see here, here is the two, the middle Bollinger Band and the two deviation Bollinger Bands. The distance is long. That means it's wide. That means there's a lot of volume volatility into the market. So you get nice movements and nice rejections. Yes. And those rejections here, for example, from this one here, yes, are telling you are really good, so you can trade. Also, this rejection here from this close opening price from the previous candle, yes, is a good rejection. So this is how you have to trade reversals, yes, based on those kind of signs. So because we are here below everything, I would enter into this trade too here on the rejection from above to below. And after this doji, because on the rejection from the 20 EMA, because we are here going into a downtrend, that is the initial of the downtrend, I would trade also this kind of candlestick. And after this, I see here, this could be a little bit tricky. It depends. I would not trade this kind of candlestick, because this hammer has already touched the Bollinger Band, yes, and the Bollinger Band is not looking like a breakout, yes, it's only something like a normal downtrend. So I would try to avoid to enter into this trade here, because I would trade this only if there would be some kind of sign of a squeeze and later a breakout, yes, that would be this one. So I would trade this kind of scenario here after this engulfing candle, yes, and that would be already all what I would have done here in this scenario. And you see, if you are patient, you can get a really nice trading setup, and you can also recognize them. So you see, I stopped to trade here in between, because I saw already that we get here in a consolidation area, and you see it was a good decision to do this, because the candlesticks here are telling nothing. So I would say that would be enough. If you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe. And if you have something to say, let me say a comment, or join the Facebook group. So I would say stay safe and bye-bye.